I wanted this lead feeder to be a high growth company, so that's why I decided to hire people early on and get financing for me to be able to do that. So I had my first employee starting 3 years ago, and now we've been tripling the employee amount each year.
We have hired actually 4 people since we started the company, and we are 9 people who's working with the Minvoice.
Me and my partner founded SnipeDB just a little bit more than 1 year ago, in 2016. And since then, we have created this company together. We have recruited a set of really talented co-workers here in Stockholm. Right now we're 15 people, and we're still growing and recruiting more.
Don't just see the CV. Don't look at their experience or what's in our paper. Actually, try them out first you hire them.
Hiring in Stockholm is really hard right now in the startup ecosystem, because you have these big unicorns that are super attractive employees. They have, you know, all the benefits you can imagine. They have good salaries and have exciting works. So they suck up a lot of talent into them. And if you then want to build your own unicorn by yourself from day one, yeah, you really have to sell a story to the people that you meet on why you should be part of this fantastic journey from day one to when we are the big unicorn.
When you hire new people to your company, obviously the first thing is to make sure that they know what you want them to do. That if you're hiring salespeople, they know how to make sales. But then in the longer run, the most important thing will be how well do they match your culture? How well do they work with others? Because this is all about teamwork. So although there would be like really perfect people technically, for example, if they cannot cooperate with others, then it's a no-go. And the only way how you can find that out is to hang out with them, do work with them. And if you see that this is not a fit, the earlier you fire them, the easier it will be for everybody.